Before you open Mistika, I would recommend going always to the Config Utility. You just double click on the Mistika Config Utility, and that will open what some Mistika operators know as the mConfig. And in the mConfig is where you're going to configure everything related to how Mistika is going to use the resources you have, how you're going to configure your video output, and how you're going to configure a Mistika to work at a specific resolution and frame rate. So everything related to your project and the resources that you have. You can see that you have standard presets, and if you click on the standard preset, that will open the preset manager. Over here, you'll see all the factory presets that get installed with Mistika. Outside, you can decide if you want to hide the VR presets because you don't do any VR work, or the other way around. Maybe you want to hide the video presets because you don't do that type of work and you're only focused on VR. You can also configure the autosave in the general tab and how many auto versions are kept, autosave versions are kept. You can also disable this inside your Mistika session. If you want to enter the advanced options, just click that tab and the mConfig would open in advanced sessions. I would only recommend this if you really have to configure things that are very specific. In file paths, in the file paths tab, you would define where your projects are and where your real-time storage is. I would always recommend choosing a very fast storage for your real-time storage, although this is something that you can define later and you don't really are going to be constrained to use only this folder. You can actually define different folder destinations for renders, for example, within a Mistika session. And actually, that's where the render paths are in play. The path builder, it will let you define render paths for all the different type of renders that you want to do. Master formats, maybe the most important one for the work that we want to do in Mistika, which is video work. Here we are going to decide the render size of our resolution of our project. Okay, we also go to decide the YUV color space that we are going to be working on in our video output, the frame rate if we need to define if it's drop frame when we're working at 2997, and if we're using a video board. I would recommend having auto adjust settings on, because as soon as you change, for example, the frame rate, it would also change the main frame rate at the master formats section. You also will have the option of configuring Mistika to work in stereo 3D and how the video output settings will be defined. If when you capture media, if it's going to be captured as YUV 422 or up to RGB 10 bits. You could also define how the sync is going to work, if it's going to be internal or you're going to use a gen lock or input number one or input number two. When you're not working with a video board, you might want to work with the motherboard audio. In codecs, you will define how you're going to work and how you're going to optimize work with EXRs, if you want to optimize any job done with single layer or multi-layer. You would also have settings, default settings, when you load R3D footage, like for example the reduce factor, and also the performance and the decoder type, if you want to use CUDA, OpenCL, or you just want to use your CPU. Also, you will have the option of configuring Dolby Vision. And then in performance options, you would have different type of performance options sort of related to playback and rendering. If anything is out of what Mistika considers correct, you will have a message advising you to change. Like for example there, I just change the units. And it would say, hey, you have more units than your current frame rate. This might create some issues. So just drop it where you feel safe. or where Mistika doesn't come with a warning, and you'll be safe there. Then an interface is where we will define a different type of configure different ways of working. Like for example, if you have a two monitor configuration, enable the two monitors toggle. You can also change the type of font that is used in the interface and the default render name that is shown in the output tab. As well, for colorist at the top, you can change to rank mode, where it's going to rotate the trackball orientation, and this might be useful for you. And then we have the tangent tab, where we can configure our connection and interaction with all the tangent control surfaces. So that is everything that you can do in the mConfig to configure your Mistika user experience in a Mistika session.